Section 4.3, the coefficient of determination. In this section, we'll look at this objective. We want to compute and interpret the coefficient of determination. The coefficient of determination, often delineated by R squared, measures the proportion of total variation in the response variable that is explained by the least squares regression line. This value will be a number between 0 and 1 inclusive, which means it could be 0, it could be 1, and anything between the two. If r squared is equal to 0, then the line has no explanatory value. If r squared equals 1, this means the line explains 100% of the variation in the response variable. So let's look again at the example we've been following throughout this module. We have the data that are based on our study for drilling rock. The first list, X, is the depth at which the drilling begins, and the second list, Y, is the time to drill, the 5 feet, in minutes. And recall, in a previous section, we created a scatter diagram, so here we see that now, with the drilling time versus the depth. And we can see that our data is trending in an upward direction. We have some sample statistics. The mean depth was 126.2 with a standard deviation of 52.2. The mean time was 6.99 with a standard deviation of 0.781. So then we found that R, our correlation between the depth and time, was 0.773. So our regression analysis, the equation we came up with is time, or our Y value, is equal to 5.53 plus 0.0116 times depth, or X. So we've written it this way as well. And remember, we found this regression line in our last section. Suppose we were asked to predict the time to drill an additional 5 feet, but we did not know the current depth of the drill. What would be our best guess? The mean time to drill an additional 5 feet was 6.99 minutes. So that would be our best guess about how long it would take. Now suppose that we are asked to predict the time to drill an additional 5 feet if the current depth of the drill is 160 feet. Now we can use the line that we found previously, our regression line, to help us answer this. So remember, the depth that the drilling begins was our x value. So in our equation, our regression line, where x is, we'll now put the value of 160 feet, and you see it here. When we evaluate this, we end up with the value 7.39. So now our guess has increased from the mean amount, 6.99 minutes, to 7.39 minutes based on the knowledge that the drill depth is positively associated with the drill time. The difference between the observed value of the response variable and the mean value of the response variable is called the total deviation and is equal to y minus y bar, which is our mean value. So we have a visual here. We have our scatter plot. The black slanted line is our regression line, and the red line through the middle is the mean value of the response variable. And we see that the total deviation then is our observed value up here minus the mean value. The difference between the predicted value of the response variable and the mean value of the response variable is called the explained deviation. And that's equal to y hat, which was what we called our regression line, the value that we got from plugging our value of x into the regression line and evaluating. Then we subtract the mean value of the response variable. And we see this here This is the difference that's explained by the drill depth. The difference between the observed value of the response variable and the predicted value of the response variable is called the unexplained deviation. So that's equal to our y value that we observed here, minus the value we got when we plugged our x value into the regression line and evaluated, which was a point on our regression line. So here we zoom in on this a little bit, and we see that the total deviation is equal then to the unexplained deviation plus the explained deviation. So it can be shown that we have this equation where the total variation then is equal to the unexplained variation plus the explained variation. So if we were to do a little algebra here and divide our equation by the total variation, we would get 1 on the left side. Then each of the values on the right side would be divided by the total variation. So then if we moved our unexplained variation over total variation, basically subtracted it from both sides, we would have that r squared is equal to the explained variation over the total variation, which is then 1 minus the unexplained variation divided by the total variation. To determine r squared for the linear regression model, we simply square the value of the linear correlation coefficient. But we need to exercise caution here a little bit. Squaring the linear correlation coefficient to obtain the coefficient of determination, r squared, works only for the least squares linear regression model. But this method does not work in general. So in this example, we want to determine the coefficient of determination. We'll find it and interpret it for our drilling data. Remember that our linear correlation coefficient, R, is 0.773, and we found that in an earlier section. So if we square that value, we have 0.773 squared, which gives us 0.5975. And we need to change this to a percent by multiplying by 100. And we get 59.75%. So 59.75% of the variability in drilling time is explained by the least squares regression line. Here we see three different sets of data, A, B, and C. We'll look at a scatter diagram for each of these data sets. For each data set, the variance of y is 17.49. So here we see our scatter diagram for data set A, data set B, and data set C. For A, we see that 99.99% of the variability in y is explained by the least squares regression line. And you can see that for this data set, the majority of the points lie in that straight line, right on top of the regression line. So this makes sense that it would be pretty high. Now for B, we notice that the points are pretty close to being in a line, but they're off a little bit. So it's not quite as high. 94.7% of the variability in Y is explained by our least squares regression line. And for data set C, we can tell that the points are pretty far from being in a straight line or from being close to our regression line. So we have only 9.4%, a much, much smaller number, of the variability in Y is explained by the least squares regression line.